illustrations of why Band-Aids can be important when you are a squirrel person. This finger right here, this is the one. Sometimes they're going to clamp on when they're new. They don't know yet. They mean well. They want the nut. They don't want to hurt you. But they don't understand yet sometimes how to handle their claws. And some of them are born with claws that are more lethal than others. I had one squirrel that I used to call Edward Scissorhands. Try as he might, he could not get the technique down. But most can, and some need a little bit of time to learn. And for those, this is the finger that you want to put a Band-Aid on. It really helps. They might, this will be the one that if they try to grab, this one tends to get grabbed. Also, sometimes if they're trying to, if you have the nut like this and they don't line up right, they could, I don't know how it happens, but sometimes your finger gets in their mouth and they bite down a little hard. Usually they don't. Even if your finger winds up in their mouth, it's nothing. You feel nothing. But sometimes you get a squirrel that kind of clamps down a little bit and you're like, whoa. And so yeah, this is a good Band-Aid finger right here. One of my more memorable Band-Aid events was with Lucy. When she was new, she wanted to take a nut from me just like all the other ones. And she came up to me like she knew just what she was doing, and I believed that she did. I give them all the benefit of the doubt, and for the most part, it all goes fine. Well, this one, it was her first time, and boy, she got confused. She grabbed hold of my finger, and I think she had my finger and her nut, and my finger and the nut in her mouth, and she didn't. I got the impression she didn't know how to like let go of the finger without letting go of the nut, so she was just kind of hanging on to everything, and so I was like, whoa, get off of me. And when I went like that, she like flipped onto her back, which I was afraid was going to make her leave forever. I came inside, took care of my finger, went back outside. And she was like, let's do it again. I'm like, dude, I need a little time to recover from the trauma that you just caused me. And yeah, she just wanted to try again. She's good now. And here's a clip of her.
Hey, Lucy.
Hey, Lucy. Come on, honey. Come on, Lucy.
What are you doing? Come on.
Come on, honey. Come on, honey. Come on.
See, Lucy is far from vicious. I haven't encountered any vicious squirrels in my time with them. When they're new and they're scared and they're afraid of hurting you, sometimes they do the very thing they fear most until they learn. If I let out a sound to let them know it hurts, they turn things around very quickly and make sure it never happens again. So that's my experience. And in the meantime, if you have a new one that's skittish and learning or you're just not sure, go with a Band-Aid for the just in case. I'm going to make you keep looking at me with these braids if you don't hit subscribe. Please hit subscribe.